I got into taxidermy at the age of 23, I think it was. I was just at that age where I was trying to find out what I wanted, and I'd done a bit of drawing and sculpting and photography, and finally kind of hit upon taxidermy because I was trying to furnish my flat with it, really. So I took a lesson in Scotland from a very traditional taxidermist, and I was just hooked straight away. One of the main challenges of being an artist is probably applies to anyone who's self-employed, really, I think, which is that it's very difficult to switch off. I'm always ultimately responsible for everything I do, everything I make, every idea I have, and I really enjoy that part of the job, but at the same time it can be quite stressful. It's quite hard to be proud of what I've done, certainly at the time that I've completed it. Well, when I look at my work when I've just finished it, all I can really see are the mistakes and all the stress that went into it and the things that you have to remake, and you're very hypercritical, I think, at that point. So it takes me quite a lot of perspective, I think, before I can actually feel proud. Other than that, I guess just the unpredictability of the job. Sales are never guaranteed for a start, and you obviously need to make money in order to be able to make new work. So you have to be constantly inventive and try to kind of always keep ahead of your buyers and make sure that you're not boring people. And yeah, it's nothing's secure, really. Even if you get relative success, it really can just dry up in a couple of weeks and it'll all be over for you. So in that respect, it makes it more exciting, but it also makes it a bit more nerve-wracking. It's difficult to know what drives you as an artist. I think it's something that's kind of innate in us, and probably in most people, really. I think creativity and producing something, I think, is probably the best form of therapy, really. I suppose if you go back hundreds of years, we would get up at the crack of dawn and we would go out and we would physically exhaust ourselves working and producing things and feeding ourselves, and we didn't really have time to sit around and think. And I think that art actually satisfies part of our lives that are kind of missing now. You know, I don't think we don't need to behave like that anymore, I suppose, because so much is done for us. And I feel very lucky that I found something that kind of saved me from that.